Hello, my dear students. A warm greetings of the day. In today's class, we are going to discuss about word problems. So let us consider the first problem. Here we have the first question. A garden has 279 mango and 183 apple trees. How many trees are there in total? So this is the first question. What is given here? Yes, we know how many numbers of mango and apple trees are there, but we have to calculate in total how many trees are there, right? So what we have to do? Very good. We have to add these two numbers of trees. Then we will get the total number of trees. So let us solve. Before solving, we have to write the statements for this problem. So we have to write what is given first. So what is given? Yes. We know number of mango trees, right? So let us write first. Number of mango trees. How many mango trees are there? Very good. 279 that we have to write in front of this statement. So the next is, what is given? Yes. Number of apple trees. So how many apple trees are there? Exactly 183. And the last statement is, we have to calculate total trees. So let us calculate. We have to solve the problem on the other side, where first we are writing the places and we have to write the first number 279, and next we have 183. We have to add these two numbers. So from where should we start? Yes, we have to start from ones place. When we add 9 and 3, what is the answer do we get? Yes, 9 plus 3 is 12. Now which number we have to write below ones place? Very good. We have to write 2 here. Then what about 1? Yes, it is carrying over to the tens place. So in tens place we have 1, 7 and 8. Now we have to add these three numbers. 1 plus 7, what is the answer? 8. Again we have to add 8 plus 8. The answer is exactly 16. So what we have to write here? Yes, we have to write 6. And 1 carrying over to the hundreds place. Now we have to add the numbers in the hundreds place. We have 1, 2 and again 1. When we add these three numbers, what is the answer do we get? Yes, 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 1, answer is 4. So we got the answer 462. That is the total trees, right? So that answer we have to write here. So this is how we solve word problem. Is it clear? Yes, good. Let us move to the next problem. So where we have the question, a shopkeeper has 566 cold drink bottles and 283 milk bottles. How many bottles does he have all together? Understood the question? What is given? Yes, we know the number of cold drink bottles and milk bottles. We have to find out how many bottles does he have all together. You can see I have underlined the word all together. So what we have to do? Yes, we have to add. See, in total, all together, these are the keywords to identify that you have to add these numbers. So we can solve the problem, right? So what we have to do first? Yes, we have to write what is given. Then we have to find out the total, right? So what is given? What is the first statement we can write here? Yes, very good. Number of cold drink bottles. So how many cold drinks bottles are there? Exactly, 566. So what is the next statement? Yes, number of milk bottles. So how many milk bottles are there? Exactly, 283. Then the last statement is, yes, total bottles. Now let us solve. First we are writing the places, and the first number is 566 plus 283. You know that we have to start from ones place. So 6 plus 3, answer is 9, right? Any carryover? No. Let us go to the tens place. Here we have 6 plus 8. When we add these two numbers, what is the answer do we get? Exactly, we get 14. So which number we have to write here? Yes, we have to write 4. And 1 carry over to the hundreds place. Now we have to add the numbers in the hundreds place. 1 plus 5, answer is 6. 6 plus 2, answer is 8. So the answer is 849. It's clear? Very good. Let's go to the next problem. A factory produced 236 bulbs on Monday, 382 bulbs on Tuesday, and 127 bulbs on Wednesday. How many bulbs were produced in all? What did you understand by this question? Yes, you know the number of bulbs produced on Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. We have to calculate total, right? All together, in all, how many bulbs were produced, correct? So we have to write the statement first. Which statement we can write first? Yes, bulbs produced on Monday. So how many bulbs produced on Monday? Exactly, 236. What is the next statement? Good. Bulbs produced on Tuesday. So how many bulbs? Correct, 382. So which is the third statement? Bulbs produced on Wednesday, right? So what is the answer? 127. Now what is the last statement? Yes, total bulbs. So we have to find out the answer now. Let us find out. So first we are writing 236, 382, 127, and we have to add plus symbol because we are adding that one. So we have to start from ones place. In ones place we have 6, 2 and 7. 6 plus 2, what is the answer? 8. 8 plus 7? Yes, very good. 15. 5 we are writing and 1 carry over to the tens place. Now 1 plus 3, answer is 4. 4 plus 8? Very good. 12. 12 plus 2? 14. So which number I have to write here? Yes, 4. And 1 carry over to the hundreds place. Now we have to add the numbers in the hundreds place. We have 1, 2, 3 and 1. We have to add these numbers. Let us add. 1 plus 2? the total bulbs produced by the factory is 745. Correct? Now let us move to the next problem. Tony sold 432 chocolates. His sister Rita sold 179 chocolates more than Tony. How many total chocolates did Rita sell? So what is the question? Once again I am going to read. Listen carefully. Tony sold 432 chocolates. His sister Rita sold 179 chocolates more than Tony. How many total chocolates did Rita sell? So what we have to find out? We know how many chocolates Tony sold, right? Do you know how many chocolates did Rita sell? No, we don't know that one. We have to find out that. But what is given? Yes, we know how many more chocolates did Rita sell than Tony, right? Yes, so we have to add them. Then we will get to know how many total chocolates did Rita sell, correct? So let us write the statement first. So what statement we can write? Yes, chocolates sold by Tony. So how many chocolates did Tony sell? Yes, it is 432. So what is the next statement? Extra chocolates sold by Rita. So how many extra chocolates Rita sold? Yes, 179. And we have to find out total chocolates sold by Rita. Now we know how many chocolates Tony sold and extra chocolates sold by Rita. We have to add these two. Then we can calculate total number of chocolates sold by Rita. So let us find out. We have 432 plus 179. We have to add from ones place. 2 plus 9. What is the answer? Yes, it is 11. So 1 is carry over to the tens place. 1 plus 3, answer is 4. 4 plus 7, answer is 11. So we have to write here 1. And 1 carry over to the hundreds place. Now 1 plus 4, answer is 5. 5 plus 1, answer is 6. So the total chocolate sold by Rita is 611. This is about word problem. I hope you all are clear with this. Now let us move to properties of addition. You know, right, how to add numbers. So when you considered addition, there are some properties. Let us discuss about it. So the first one is the sum of two numbers is the same when we change the order of numbers. When we add two numbers, their sum will be same even though we change the order of it. This is called commutative property of addition. So let us consider one example. Here we have number 378 plus 435. Now when we add these two numbers, we'll get the answer 813. Right? You can add and check once again. Is it correct? Yes, the answer is 813. Now, if we change the order of number, let us write 435 first, then add 378. So what will be the sum? Is it different or same? Yes, it is same, right? Here also we will get the answer 813. So even though we change the order, the sum remains the same. This is called commutative property of addition. Clear? Okay, let's move to the next property. The sum of three numbers is the same when we change the groupings of numbers. So when you change the grouping of the numbers, the sum of three numbers remains the same, and this is called associative property of addition. Let us consider example. Here we have 26 plus 15 plus 10. Now we have grouped the number. First we are going to add 26 plus 15. That we have grouped, right? We have put a bracket, that is one group. Then we are adding 10. So let us add this first. When you add 26 plus 15, what is the answer do we get? We get 41. Now 41 plus 10. Again we are adding 41 plus 10. So the answer we get is 51. Now we are changing the group. Let us make different group. Here 26 plus 15 plus 10. Now we have made another group. We have made the group of 15 plus 10. We are adding that number first. So let us add and see what is the answer we are going to get. 26 plus 25. When we add 15 plus 10, we get the answer 25. Now we add 26 plus 25. The answer is 51. So even though we change the group, the sum remains the same, right? This is called associative property of addition. Let us move to one more property. When 0 is added to a number, or a number is added to 0, the sum is the number itself. So this is called additive property of 0. So what this property says? When 0 is added to any number, or a number is added to 0, the sum is the number itself. So let us consider the example. Here we have 255 plus 0. So what is the answer? Yes, answer is 255 itself. In the same way, if 0 is added to a number, the answer is that number itself. This is about the properties of addition. So that's all for today. Along with this video, the homework problem will be attached. Thank you.